This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 14, beginning at verse 4. Starting at verse 3, and it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord Yahweh shall give thee rest from thy sorrow and from thy fear and from the hard bondage wherein thou wast made to serve. Verse 4, that thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon and say, how hath the oppressor ceased, the golden city ceased? Verse 5, the Lord Yahweh hath broken the staff of the wicked and the scepter of the rulers. Verse 6, he who smote the people in wrath with a continual stroke, he that ruled the nations in anger is persecuted and none hindereth. Skipping to verse 11, thy pomp is brought down to the grave and the noise of thy vows. The worm is spread under thee and the worms cover thee. Verse 12, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground which did weaken the nations? Verse 13, for thou hast said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of Yahweh. I will sit upon Salaki. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. Verse 14, I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Verse 15, yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. It's the book of Luke, chapter 10. Verse 18. Luke 10 and 18, and he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning falling from Salakia. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Verse 19, behold, I give unto you the power to tread on serpents and scorpions and all over the power. And over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 47, beginning at verse 1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. Sit on the ground. There is Salaki, come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. There is no throne, O daughters of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Verse 2, take the millstones and grind meal. Uncover thy locks, make bare the leg. Uncover the thigh, pass over the rivers. Verse 3, thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Kol Haloyim, La Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Rachah, Kodesh Baruch Hu. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations to the Akim across the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth with faith and sincerity and risking their lives and freedom to do so. Shalom to the Akwath and the Akim out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this is an edifying lesson. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of other nations, appearing like the other nations, with whom subscribing to this truth. To you I say shalom. The brother Yahweh Sop out of the GMS Cleveland Church, a fellow servant, coming at you with another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Basically doing a quick video an article I came across, because, you know, through the spirit, I guess it's switching up. You know, I tend to do a lot of videos about the stab and jab. And for the last, like, I want to say 3-4 days, maybe a week. Well, no, this has been going on because I've had to create like 3 other channels. And then, you know, it's funny because I've created new channels. You know how your first strike literally is just a warning, so you should still be able to upload. Well, the administrators are keeping me from even uploading on them. So, at the end of the day, knowing that's showing me the time that we're approaching, you know what I mean? Showing you can't literally, you know, it's all ultimately the will of Yahweh Shem Yahushua, because when he brings the famine of the word is because the will of Yahweh Shem Yahushua. It ain't necessarily Esau. You know, it tells you in scripture that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of man. You know, it tells you that the Most High orders the steps of men. So, you know, like I said, I was doing videos on the stab and jab, but, you know, while they're censoring that, you can't say anything about MLB, you can't say anything about the stab and jab, anything as form of any kind of anything in regards to the stab and jab, sicknesses, anything, or you're getting flagged and they're taking your video down. They might delete your whole channel. Depends, it's all actually the will of Yahweh Shah. But not to digress, I got this. I was checking out New York Post, different news publications, because like I said, my thing is, they say it's medical misinformation, but I'm reading out of articles. I got a Newsbreak app, so I'm reading out of articles that coming out of their medias. You know what I mean? They saying that's still not good. And then I was gonna try and appeal it, but for whatever odd reason, I can't appeal it. You know what I mean? Maybe if I go to an actual computer, because I'm using a phone, and the phone kind of outdated, I guess. Maybe that's why it's not letting me do it. I don't know. It could just be spiritual. You know what I mean? But long story short, the main focus they're trying to distract you from is anything about this stab and jab, or that MOB. Right now, brother's been going in on that MOB that DARPA wants to, do, which is just, and you're gonna have simple ass people that's gonna be willing to take that, because at the end of the day, more people who are friends of the world than actually, servants and followers of Yahweh. And that's why majority of the world's gonna be, I mean, two-thirds of our people especially gonna be destroyed, along with these the elite Edomites. And the Edomites are going to slavery first, then they're gonna be destroyed. But not to digress, this is a whole situation that nobody's paying attention to, because you got some people that's act, right now you got a lot of people enjoying the fruits of other people's labor, like I say, they're saying that basically you got the workforce is having trouble actually rehiring people, because nobody wants to work because the government's giving away free money. On top of the fact, which I believe to a certain extent, although it's that's misconstrued too, because like I said, I recently lost my job, and I know a guy at the height of the pandemic last year. Well, not a guy. He in the truth, he's one of the brothers. He said it took him 3 weeks to get his determination and be approved and everything. I'm going on a month. And when I first signed up for it, it was saying that you have a record number of claims. So they're telling you that the job numbers are, unemployment is down, but in actuality, if you got more people claiming or making claims, then that means it's up. That don't take a rocket scientist or whatnot. But you got people that's benefiting from this, and then you got people that's actually in situations like this. Because everybody's not getting, blessed out of this. I believe it's blessings with all this free money that's just floating around, but all of it is, it serves a purpose, because at the end of the day, they have to crash the dollar to bring in the digital dollar, So, and homelessness actually has arisen. You got to remember that more moratorium, that eviction moratorium, although that's supposed to have been in place and whatnot, then you come to find out they ruled it unconstitutional. I just was watching looking at an article or Newsbreak. It was talking about, it was a couple that literally, even though it's a moratorium, they still being evicted. You had during the moratorium last year, in California, people were still getting evicted. So, I mean, this is gonna be bad. It says shocking footage from Philadelphia zombie skid row, which you don't have just one in Philadelphia. I had the opportunity to visit the brothers in LA, in 19, 2019, and literally, like, I was in Long Beach, literally, like. The motel we were staying at, that it was a skid row over there. You know what I mean? Like, so it's skid rows everywhere, because you got more people actually struggling right now. Like, these people, do you really think that they actually received a stimulus? I mean, if they stand on the streets, how are they going to get the paper checks? Says shocking footage from Philadelphia zombie skid row shows groups of opioid-addicted homeless men struggling to stand amid needle-littered streets of filth and trash campfires. And this is the reason why I did the video and came out with those scriptures, because Babylon the Great has pretty much fallen. You know what I mean? It's just an illusion that is still going on. You got more places that appear like this than you do. I'm a testament to that. I've actually been in a situation. I was actually homeless. You know what I mean? The Lord had to put me down low, and then he brought me, He lifted me up, you know. Call haloyim la yah ba shem el shah. But at the end of the day, this is the testament to where it's going to go. Because at the end of the day, if you don't have if you don't have an actual real economy, you know what I mean? You don't, because you got more people now, I mean, you know, feel entitled to shit. I'm gonna take this government free money. You got people that, you know, that was literally working at McDonald's and making three times, well, you know, I'll say more than half of what they was making at McDonald's. They're making, well, shit, we gonna say three times as much, making it for just sitting on their ass. You know what I mean? You know, and then the thing is, they extended it so much so that, because you gotta remember, like, I mean, this happened in, really in 2020. You know what I mean? And then this is a whole year of them extending unemployment and passing legislation and different bills to keep on funding the government and whatnot. And then I was looking at a video prior to this about how they was talking about, you gotta remember, just last year you had the banks had to borrow money from the feds, and the Fed had to actually pump billions of dollars into the economy. People completely forgot about all that. And they don't feel or believe that that's gonna have any repercussions. But when you understand and go into, you know, how a fiat currency works, you know what I mean? You know, of course the Fed will just continue to pump in money, but yet still that money has to be accounted for. You know what I mean? Like I said, I always bring up the fact that overabundance of something makes it actually it devalues it. You know, when you go into Mexico, you know, the reason why it takes 500 pesos to buy, you know, or even Colombia, you know what I mean? Like in Colombia and Venezuela and whatnot, like, you know, like I knew a guy I worked with. He would go, this is what he would do for vacation. He would go over to Venezuela and literally go kick it with females. And he was a big trick, but these women were beautiful, you know what I mean? He like, well, shit, you know what I mean? Because their economy was so fucked up. I mean, you know, brothers did videos about this. You know, you had women that was doctors and scientists that actually end up having to sell their kibbeh just because of the fact they couldn't eat because the economy fucked up. So he would go over there. I'll never forget it. He was going over there. He'd go over there with a couple $1,000. We, I mean, you know, that wasn't a super bad job. They got bonuses and shit like that. So, you know, they would take, he would go over there every year, once a year, and he would I think he would talk to a lot of the females over like one of those, you know, social media platforms, probably like Skype or something. And he would go over there and he would, you know, basically court them, but he would be, in his mind, I guess I don't know how he was looking at it, but I know, you know, what he's giving them wasn't shit to him. He's looking at it like, you know, it's like you're taking a female out on a date here, but to her, that's like benefiting her whole family. You know what I mean? So, yeah. But Salakia, for the digression, it says video from Kingston Avenue section of Philadelphia shows rapid drug use and homelessness. Addicts can be seen brandishing needles out in the open along drag known for being open air drug market. And the thing is, when I went to LA, we preached downtown and they downtown. And I don't believe they preach down there anymore. I think because, I mean, when I look at the current videos, they're not downtown. All the camps used to teach downtown. But I remember going down there and it was like, it kind of reminds you of New York. You know, it's busy and a whole bunch of people. But I didn't know Chicago was like that. Chicago was busy with a whole bunch of people out and about. You know what I mean? Make Cleveland look pathetic. You know what I mean? But even Detroit was busier. They downtown was busier than ours. But, I'll never forget it. I mean, I've seen people do drugs out in the open. You know what I mean? I've been homeless, but they—I mean, they're right downtown, and the motherfucker just do a mega blast. Like I'm like, wow, it was crazy. So this is—I mean, this is the new normal. Situations have deteriorated to the point where train stations was forced to shut down after it was overrun. Feces and litter were seen in elevators leading to train platforms, and transit workers said they were threatened. Homeless men lie on the sidewalk while others wearing blankets and rags loiter on a street strewn with garbage, feces, and drug paraphernalia along the notorious Kingston Avenue drag in Philadelphia. Video posted online shows on March 10th shows people living out of suitcases on the sidewalk and the area adjacent to the entrance to the Somerset train station along the Market Frankfort train line, while others openly brandish needles. So I wasn't gonna play any video. I'm just gonna let y'all look at the pictures. It said cardboard boxes with trash bags stacked on top of them, light feet away from the entrances to various pawn shops, checks cashing stores, delis, and bodegas. So this is obviously the city is allowing this just to take place. You know, it makes me think of how, what was that, The Wire? Remember, they sectioned off Baltimore, a portion of Baltimore, and they just allowed that area to be drug infested and strewn, drug, you know, littered and whatnot. And they basically supposed to kept crime down. But how do you figure when crime is all happening right there? You know, and now it's funny because that was a show, but in actuality, you got certain cities that's actually doing this. This appears to be one. I know Baltimore basically said they're no longer going to be prosecuting anything petty as far as what they consider petty, like prostitution or drug possession. It says rapid drug use and homelessness could be observed near the intersection of Kingston Avenue and Somerset Street in Philadelphia. And the thing is, you know, I've been enough of these government programming and, you know, in and out of the system and whatnot. And, you know, they understand that when you're in a position like this, when you are brought that low, most people, like, I've been homeless. I mean, you know, I mean, I was drinking before I was homeless, but I would admit I probably drank the reason why. Well, this truth that, you know what I mean? Like, I just was listening to the elders say, they was talking about how Yahweh Shah, you know, you dealing with Jake, hard-headed-ass niggas, and then, you know, yeah, no wonder why the Messiah drank. But on top of it, you know, it's because it's depressing, you know what I mean? And people look for escape when they're depressed. Very few people could just sit up there and be, optimistic and just cheerful in that situation. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, you see people that got a house, a home, a family, and still miserable. So, you know, Salakia says the image above shows a man holding a needle. All right. There you go. You see him. Kingston Avenue is known as a go-to destination for drug addicts and dealers who can obtain cheap narcotics. The image above shows people covered in blankets as they sleep on pieces of cardboard on a sidewalk strewn with leather. Litter. The image above shows a man sleeping on the sidewalk of Kingston Avenue in Philadelphia. The Kingston section of Philadelphia was once a blue-collar factory neighborhood that was devastated by deindustrialization of the 1950s and the subsequent white flight to the suburbs. So basically, they had, you know, jobs down there, and then they took those jobs away, and all the Edomites ran with the money. And that became just a poverty-strewn area. I forgot what rapper speaks about that. I don't want to get the quote and be wrong, so I'm going to just digress. Several people are covered in blankets as they sleep on pieces of cardboard surrounded by... Okay, we read all that. I'm going to show you. Just keep on showing the images. So litter and debris could be seen strewn across the sidewalk of Kingston Avenue. While the video was taken while there was sunlight outside, economic activity in the area appears to be non-existent. And you can see all the stores look boarded up and closed as stores are shuttered. The area is known to several pubs and Chinese takeout joints. The intersection of Somerset and Kingston Avenue has earned various nicknames, including the Walmart of heroin, Philadelphia Skid Row, and the latest open-air drug market on the East Coast. Several people could be seen sleeping on the sidewalk using blankets to cover themselves. Kingston is known among addicts as an area where they can get both the cheapest and purest heroin in the area. Dealers, so they just repeating a lot of the same stuff. Says dealers from as far as Delaware, Maryland, and New Jersey frequent the area to stock up on supplies before returning home to peddle the narcotics, according to the New York Times. And like I said, 9 times out of 10, Esau has a hand in all this. You know what I mean? It's not by coincidence, and that brings money to the economy. You know what I mean? You know, you got to remember, this is the same country where you had, the freeway Ricky Ross, you know? They funded a fucking war based on this man selling drugs throughout the country, you know? So, I mean, this is the kind of devil you deal with, you know? So, best believe, you know, come on. Amongst the addicts, you got people from other cities and states that come there and buy drugs in bulk to go back to sell in their own city. And you don't think, you know what I mean? Like, that don't make, I mean, okay. It says in 2017, 236 people suffered fatal overdoses as a result of drugs they purchased and used in Kingston. More than 1,200 people fatally overdosed in Philadelphia in 2016. And then it's going into fentanyl.
The city saw a large spike in the number of fatal overdoses. The opioid problem deteriorated to the point where Philadelphia officials wanted to allow the opening of a safe injection site. Safe, listen to this madness. Safe injection sites are locations where people can shoot up under the supervision. That's funny, though. When you take the time to think about it, like, it's ironic, really. It's, you know, it's the lore, you know, balance. Because, you know, remember, I'm old enough to remember the crack epidemic. Not to the point of, like, you know, because at one point in time, you had our people and pretty much is. You know, you had our people that everybody, I ain't gonna say everybody, but for the most part, a lot of people experimented. Like, a lot of people experimented with marijuana, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, you know, now when the crack epidemic hit, you know, you had Jake going to jail, getting caught with a few stones, going to jail for years, you know what I mean? Or getting caught with a quarter ounce of crack, while Edom might get caught with an ounce of cocaine, but get a least severe sentence than Jake. Now you got injection sites. Oh my God. You know, just showing you, and then you still talking about you feel you equal to this fucking devil. From opponents of, I made myself mad. These is more images. Well, that's feces, and that's people sleeping in the elevators. That's them sleeping inside the transit systems. And this is coming to America, because at the end of the day, you basically dividing this place from the haves and the have-nots. You know what I mean? And eventually, when you go into all these zombie apocalypse movies, it's, you know, the CDC is supposed to have some information on their website talking about how to deal with a zombie and during the zombie apocalypse and whatnot. But for the most part, you know, those movies like I Am Legend and what's that movie called with Brad Pitt? I can't think of the name of it. It was with the zombies and whatnot. Literally, that's most of these morgues out here where you go have the have-nots. It's going to be more of them than it's going to be those that have. And, you know, you go have a zombie apocalypse scenario. Since Zach and Bree moving their belongings out of Subway, they have been happening for the past several months. So they must have just cleared it out. Yeah, that's a rough life. You know what I mean? Scriptures talk about that. Talks about, matter of fact, let me get it. House to house, for where thou art a stranger, thou darest not open thy mouth. Open thy mouth. And that's the point. It's a miserable life to have to live in a way or a manner where you have to actually rely on somebody else to provide for you, and it's not your own. Like I said, I had to do that before, and you know, that before this thing was over, he allowed me to actually have my own, you know. At the end of the day, you know, like I say, that's not no joke. So I'm gonna end the lesson with that. You know what I mean? Well, not end the lesson. I'm gonna bring out some more scriptures. You know what I mean? So this is a very graphic and detailed article, because it's showing you actual footage. But for the most part, people are vain. They're not gonna actually actually relate or give to, you know, they're not going to really care too much about these images, you know what I mean? Especially nowadays, you know what I mean? You know, so let me get some closing precepts, because at the end of the day, this is America's future, you know? Let me see. Book of Isaiah 20,
for Book of Isaiah chapter 24 verse 10. The city of confusion is broken down. Every house is shut up that no man may come in. Verse 11. There is crying for wine in the streets. All joy is darkened. The mirth of the land is gone. And although you got people appearing to be enjoying themselves, having fun, you know, the mirth is truly gone. You can see that when they opened up spring break. And all those Jakes from all the different cities and states went down there and did. What did they do? The Lord had put a spirit on them to shut that shit down and put a curfew. They put a state of emergency in place and put a curfew so you couldn't even enjoy yourself with the money in your pocket, because this was the perfect time to enjoy yourself. You know, people got income tax, got they had got that stimulus. Yeah. You know, they coming up with incentives to give out more money. That's how you know that they crashing the economy. We are in the last days. You know, that's a measure of the times that we're in. You know, them just printing out all this free money. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 10. Salakia, this is the book of Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 17. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, behold, I will send upon them, meaning, this is really talking about, those nations. Well, talking about Babylon the Great, you know what I mean? Thus said the Lord of hosts, behold, I will send upon them the sore and famine and the pestilence, and will make them like vile figs and cannot be eaten. They are so evil. Verse 18, I will persecute them with the sore, with the famine, with the pestilence. And the sore, you got our people, especially 2/3 of our people, getting knocked down left and right by Esau's sword. These cops are shooting Jake left and right, with the famine. You see, the price of these foods go up, and the pestilence, which is this stab and jab with this whole plandemic, you know what I mean? That's a pestilence, because you got people getting a stab and jab, and literally, they're being plagued with adverse reactions, getting infirmities, people actually dying, and I will persecute them with the sword, with the famine, and with the pestilence, and I will deliver them to be removed to all kingdoms of the earth, to be a curse and a reproach among all the nations, whether I have driven them. Let's talk about Jake too. It's the book of Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 7. This is Jeremiah 51 and 7. No, I'm going to start at verse 6. I'm going to start at verse 5. Jeremiah 51 and 5. Because you're going to have, the book of 2 Ezra chapter 9 talks about that. You're going to have people that's refuse to hearken unto the law, statutes, commandments. This is Jeremiah 51 and 5. For Israel have not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power of the Lord of hosts, though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel. Flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. He will render unto her a recompense, meaning he's going to repay or reward her for, for her many iniquities. This is a very sinful, wicked ass place. Babylon have been a golden cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunken. The nations have drunken of her wine. Therefore, the nations are mad. The nation's mad just based on this whole fiat currency, this petrodollar. You know what I mean?
I was just reading, well, I was skimming over an article. They was talking about China and Russia trying to get and bypass this dollar, because at the end of the day, it was it, I mean, and that's all because of Yahweh Shem Yahusha. All the nations are kind of tied to the petrodollar, and that's why all the nations are gonna have to be tied to a digital currency, Babylon, verse 8, Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. How for her, take balm for her pain, if so be she may be healed. Verse 9, we would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Because this place can't be healed. This place, it tells you in the book of Revelation, the sins of this place have reached on to the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahusha. You see in all this unexplainable phenomenon that's happening with weather pattern. Everybody was so befuddled and confounded by the fact that it snowed on April 1st and whatnot. You know what I mean? But it's not really confounding. It was the will of Yahweh Shem Yahusha. It said, we would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go, everyone, into his own country, for her judgment reacheth unto heaven and is lifted up even to the skies. And that's when this place is going to be judged with them ICBMs. That smoke is going to reach up to the heavens, when this place is bombarded with with those ICBMs. I got one last scripture that I'm going to end the lesson. Because at the end of the day, this is just a prelude of this place being done. You ever seen like a person that actually have a deadly wound, but they still functioning? And you know what I mean? Like that's what it would be. This place is dead. You know what I mean? But because like Man on Fire, that movie with Denzel Washington, when he went got the kidnapped little Edomite girl back. You know what I mean? He was already dying. You know what I mean? But the people that kidnapped her didn't realize that. You know what I mean? He knew he was dying. These elites know this place dead. You know what I mean? Only people that don't know it's dead is you Morkmans and you two-thirds. You know what I mean? Y'all thinking this shit really gonna bounce back. You know what I mean? Like, no, this shit is over with. You know what I mean? Whenever you gotta talk about, listen here, they done passed what, four stimulus? I mean, well, they're talking about the fourth stimulus now. I don't even think that one actually is going to actually be any money for the citizens. But who's to say? You know what I mean? Like they talk about, people really think because they're going to talk about putting money into the economy and fixing the infrastructure, like that shit going to do something. I mean, wait till when they literally. Like they talk about they're not mandating the immunity passports, yada yada yada, but that's all smoke screens and mirrors, you know what I mean? Like at the end of the day, like Esau is a master manipulator, you know what I'm saying? Like at the end of the day, they gonna want a system in place to show that you actually took this inoculation. What better system than the immunity passport? You got other countries that got it. Israel got something like that. Okay, a certain state might not be able to, might not agree to it. And I don't know. I mean, you got to remember, it was certain states that didn't agree to lock down. You know what I mean? When you go into that movie Bushwhack, it's a reason why they had Texas as a state that literally, that was seceding from the United States. It's the reason why they use Texas as the state. And then, when you go into actually researching it, Texas is the only state that actually is not built on like our national grid. They have their own power system. So, this is the book of Seth. I think I already got it opened up. It's the book of Zephaniah, chapter 1, verse 14. The great day of the Lord Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahusha, is near. It is near and hastened greatly. Even the voice of the day of the Lord Yahweh, the mighty man, shall cry there bitterly. When you go into mighty man, whom are the mighty men? Mighty men are these elites, these wealthy elite bankers and those that actually have sustenance on this side, you know what I mean? In this queendom, you know what I mean? They shall cry out there bitterly. You know, when you go into the book of James, I think it's chapter 5, it talks about weeping how rich men, roughly paraphrased. Because at the end of the day, the people that's going to mourn this place the most is the people that made the most money here. You know what I mean? This is a place of, you know, it's a merchant city. You know, I believe the book of Revelation chapter 18 talks about that. You know, the merchants shall weep bitterly. The people that made money here. Because the elites make a lot of money here. You got to hear that, you know. Verse 15, that day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. I'm going to skip to verse 17, and I will bring distress upon men that they walk slacky, and I will bring distress upon men that they shall walk like blind men because they have sinned against the Lord Yahweh, while Yahweh Shah, and their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh is dung. Verse 18, neither their silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath, but the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of his jealousy, for he shall make even a speedy riddance of all them that dwell in the land. That's self-explanatory, you know. So silver and gold is not going to be what that's going to save you. The book of Ezekiel tells you they're going to cast the silver and the gold in the streets. You know, but it's going to be your righteousness and your works and your faith that's going to save you in that day. So if you're a so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American, Seminole, Indian, West Indian, and Haitian, I implore you to come back to the law, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shah, be destroyed. And with that, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Kol Haloyim, La Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shah, Baal Shem, Rachak, Odos Pekatam. Double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations to the occupant across the four corners of the earth, pushing his truth with faith and sincerity and risking their lives and freedom to do so. Shalom to the Akwath and the occupant out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this is an edifying video. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of other nations, appearing like the other nations. Subscribe to this truth. To you, I say shalom. Until next time, Lord willingly, shalom, shalom, and mawath labobah, shalom.